kid, my mama had this dog. It's a little poodle named Sammy. And he used to do all kind of tricks, like walk on his hind legs, spin around in circles, you know, all that cute little poodle shit. And one day, my mama was walking and she ran into this pit bull. And it looked mean, but she gave it the benefit of the doubt. She put her hand out to pet it and growled at her. Well, little Sammy, he wanted to protect her from that pit, so he started barking at it, and that was all it took for that pit to put little Sammy on his back, wrap his jaw around his neck, and kill him. Mama didn't do nothing about it. She thought maybe it was Sammy's fault. He shouldn't have barked.
Amy?
Hey.
Hey.
You know, I forgot something inside. I'm just gonna run back in, and you know what? You can go ahead. I'm just gonna catch another ride.
I mean, are you sure? I mean, it's all good. I don't mind waiting for you. I mean, not in a hurry or anything.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Couple of weeks passed. Pitt did the same thing to her neighbor's cat. And then to the laundromat owner's dog. Mama always felt guilty that she never warned nobody about that pit.
Anymore. People think being a celebrity is easy. And they're right. Thanks to Alpha No Drone Security.
I hate drones.
What the? Signal's gone. Where's my drone?
Thanks Alpha No Drone Security.
That's it? I like the fact that you're using drones as not only part of the problem, but also the solution.
You do. Cool.
We think we can start with high-end security for clients like celebrities.
How far along is it?
Ready for you to try a full-fledged demo.
Do you think you guys could take a trip up to Tahoe? I've got a property up there on the lake, about 10 acres.
Absolutely. Thank you for the opportunity.
Look, I get pitched about 30 phone apps a week. But as a venture capitalist, I find your technology to be refreshing.
Well, like the video says, keeps people out. I'm not sure about the bears, though. Cabin.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
That's like family guy.
I still need you to clean and to restock the bathrooms before you split.
Yes, sir.
You're taking a $15 an hour stroll? I got a Tom Cushing on the line in there for you. That's your probation officer, right?
97.
That's how many days you got left not to violate and fuck up your parole.
Yeah,
And a parolee starts missing meetings.
Showing up late for work. My mind starts to wander, you know?
Maybe I ought to start mentioning some of this shit in my reports, you know, just to cover my ass.
I don't think either one of us wants that, do we?
Listen, I'm not gonna say anything if you don't.
Oh.
Just make sure your ass is at that meeting tonight, man.
I gotta go.
Gary, I'm an alcoholic.
Hey, Gary.
The holidays are coming up. Crazy, right? Needless to say, the holidays are tough on me, and I know a lot of you feel the same way, and so let's just be especially there for one another right now. You know, I wouldn't make it through without you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Gary.
Anyone else? Kyle?
Yeah, I don't really want to talk about it. That's it.
Thanks, Kyle. How about the birthday boy with his brand new 6-year chip? Hold up your chip, Pete. Come on.
Yeah, Pete. All right. I guess I'll go. My name's Pete, and I'm an alcoholic. I used to think drinking was my problem. Then I met Gary. I quickly found out I was full of shit.
Quickly? I think it took about a year, Pete.
Turns out my issue was anger. Justified anger is the worst kind of anger for an alcoholic. And I found that out the hard way. Across the bay in San Quentin. Which I do not recommend, by the way.
Yo, Pete, wait up. Hey, I want to talk to you.
I'm sorry, I gotta get to work.
I thought you just came from work. Oh, you're still working at that bar. No wonder you've been missing meetings lately. You P.O. know about this? You know, he called me this morning, asked about you. Yeah, I gotta tell him the truth.
I get it, it's not your fault. If you gotta tell him the truth, tell him the truth. I'm just letting you know. I'm just trying to make the fucking rent this month, okay?
You hang out in a barbershop long enough, you're bound to get a haircut, Pete.
All right, you're right. Listen, I will give my notice soon, okay?
All right, man, you do what you gotta do.
Slammed about an hour ago. Oh, by the way, thank you so much for switching shifts with me. I started teaching this killer hot yoga class on weeknights, and Thursday's my only free night. Oh my god, do you take hot yoga? You? Never mind.
What? What the fuck?
Todd, you got a mistake here on the schedule. You got Fiona on Thursday nights. That's my night.
No. She's killing weeknights, man.
Yeah, well, ever since you took weekends away from me, I mean, Thursday night's my only good night. It pays my bills.
There's a thing called Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter. Do you know how to use those? Because I
don't think you do. Fiona, on the other hand, she's whip smart, she's kicking ass, and she's promoting the hell out of us. We've like quadrupled our crowd. Now we're pouring $11 Moscow mules out of copper cups, man. I do not want to go back to Bud Light.
Todd, I am social. I mean, you know me, man. I keep the drinks pouring.
All right, guys, I am closing out here. Pete is going to take care of you for the rest of the night.
Dude, aren't you rent controlled anyway?
Yeah, for now.
Sorry.
I can do that.
Hi, Susan.
Are you on your way home?
Yeah.
Ed and Karen are coming over for dinner tomorrow night, and apparently Ed doesn't do California wines, and that's all we have in the cellar.
All right, what kind do you want?
Why don't you pick up a nice French Zin?
Cops ain't gonna do nothing. Ain't got nothing on me. If they show up and arrest me for beating your ass, I'll find you. I never forget face. You hear me? Square-ass, modern family-looking motherfucker. Hey, you hear me?
Come on, man. You over 21?
bitch what you think.
Yeah, I believe you. Why you celebrate?
My lucky day.
You want a box?
No, I'm good.
Excuse me.
Fucking Old Navy, motherfucker.
Jeez. That's paper from this morning. That old news by now.
Yeah, well, ever since I lost my cable, it's the only entertainment I have.
It's free. Take it. Don't worry about it.
You sure?
Yeah, take it. You don't have a smartphone, huh?
Smartphone? No.
No.
I intend to keep it that way. You have a good night, Mr. Wong. Thanks for the paper.
Yes, of course. You too.
Peter.
Hey, Ned.
I thought best to tell you in person.
You're selling a building, I heard.
Actually, the building's sold.
Oh.
So I wanted to drop by and give you as much of a head start as I could. I mean, I know how hard it is to find a new place to live.
How soon are we talking here, Ned?
You got a place to go?
Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me.
No, I wish I were, Peter. I'll have a relocation check for you ASAP.
Come on, dude.
Atta girl.
Guest in the house tonight. He's an Oakland native, and he just so happens to be my dad, all the way from San Francisco. Dad, come on up here.
Sure thing.
So, Dad.
What do you want?
True confession, I had an ulterior motive for asking you to join me on stage tonight.
Not just to embarrass your father?
I'd really like it if you sang a duet with me at the wedding.
What? What, are you crazy?
No, it's not crazy. It'll be amazing.
I don't know. It's 150 people.
Dad, I'll never ask for anything from you ever again. We'll rehearse twice a week.
I don't know. You know, I haven't done anything like this in a long time. And, you know, ever since...
She would want you to do it.
Ah, Jesus, okay.
Really?
Yes, but I'm not gonna dance.
Fine, but you're still coming to the party tomorrow night, right?
Oh, you mean the pre-wedding party party?
Yes, that's the party. All of my friends are gonna be there. They haven't seen you in years.
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Nice. I'm dancing like a goddamn Jabberwocky at the party.
That's exactly why I'm gonna leave the dancing to you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
to having a good time.
So my offer still stands. If you wanted to be a surprise for Natalie, I could teach you to dance. For real. No, look, I don't know if you know this, but you're white. And so you may need my help.
I think I'll pass, okay? But hey, listen. On a more serious note, I didn't want to say anything in front of Natalie.
You're not dying, are you?
Dying? What?
No! Fuck no, what the fuck? No, I'm not dying.
Can't hit me with that heavy shit.
Dude, no. I saved up some money. I want to give you guys some money.
Oh, no. No. My parents got this, bro. Natalie didn't tell you? Look, okay, I know traditionally the father of the bride is supposed to...
Go on.
Pete.
Hey, look, your parents are great, okay? It's just... Ever since I got back in Natalie's life, it's been really hard to do that. And I owe her so much. I owe you so much. I'm going to owe you when I get older, even more.
Oh, man. Look, we love you, bro. We love you. Come on, man.
I appreciate that, but I want you to take this money and maybe use it for a honeymoon or whatever, okay?
All right. Thanks, man.
I really wish you still drank, bro.
Oh, no, you don't.
What?
No, you don't.
I could drink you under the table. I know you're a big dude.
Sure you could, but I'm going to tell you right now, you don't even want to see me try. All right.
Thanks, Pete.
A gruesome discovery has people in this quiet San Francisco neighborhood feeling a bit on edge.
Are you with me? Oh, Harry.
Police were called to an alley off Grant Street at around 5 a.m. this morning. After
oh, come on, Harry.
Discovered a body left.
Hey, you're the one that set the quota for three times a week, not me.
33-year-old Frederick Ross of Oakland.
I thought it was four.
If you have any information that could help out our investigators, please do contact the San Francisco Police Department.
I know we are going through a drought, but I feel like being bad. I am going to take a 20-minute shower, and I don't give a shit. The environment is going to suck my dick. We're talking about politics, I think, more on the other than the ether than now. I'm just getting the foundation on.
Yeah, okay. We can do anything we want.
It's a fucking Tesla. This is a damn good Zin. Where did you say you got it from again?
France.
Yes.
That's the last bottle right there.
Oh, no.
You're just going to have to drink a little slower, Ed. Yeah. Maybe that way you can actually savor it. Honey, please unplug. We have company.
It's okay. That is the society we live in now.
Mm-hmm.
We all have to update our status at all times.
Well, Harold doesn't do social media.
That's because he's a grown-up.
Shut up, Ed. You have a Facebook and a Twitter page. So why don't you do social media?
I think it brings out the worst in humanity.
How so?
Makes everyone think they're special, but deep down, everyone's just a troll. Well, that's why people on the internet love anonymity, because they can finally feel free to say whatever they want. It's kind of like guns.
Harry.
Guns and trolls. Wow, this Zin is incredible. What's taking us down a rabbit hole?
People don't carry guns for protection. What they really want is for someone to give them the excuse to use it. Go on, burglarize my house. Let's see what happens. Snatch my purse. You make them pay the ultimate price just for fucking with the wrong person. That is everyone's fantasy, right?
Tell us how you really feel, honey.
You know, I want to propose a toast to your foundation, from Silicon Valley to Washington, D.C. Sensible gun law change is coming, and it's all because of your generosity.
At the end of the day, we all just want the world to be a safer place, right?
Yeah. Cheers.
Hello?
I guess you checked my phone.
I have to take this.
Please don't. I'm sorry.
Harold Price, June 23rd, 1963.
And do any of the charges look suspicious to you, or are they all incorrect?
No, all of those charges are correct.
Okay, thank you, sir. And your other account looks correct?
Yes, both accounts.
Okay, great. So nothing looks suspicious?
No, everything seems normal.
Is there anything else we can help you with?
No, thank you.
Credit?
Yeah.
Chip card just inserted.
You don't check ID?
You have gray hair. You're over 21, I think. Have a good night.
Is that your security camera?
Why?
Where do you keep the recordings to that?
Cinnamon. This is Crystal. What's your name?
Harold. Fuck yeah, you are. Booyah.
You're so bad.
Man, I'm tripping.
Harold ain't got no limits.
You know what I'm saying? Get over here, girl.
Jesus.
Box boy. How about you show me what they taught you in prison?
What are you doing here?
You thirsty?
So guy gets beat to death with brass knuckles. So what?
So what? Nobody uses brass knuckles.
Well, almost nobody. Doesn't mean it's the same guy.
I don't believe this. If I gave you this information 6 years ago, you would have gone batshit crazy.
Yeah, well, 2 years in prison will do that to you.
Do what?
Make you think twice about doing something stupid. Like listening to you.
That's not the only thing you did in prison. Hit that commissary every night, huh? But they give you your last meal every fucking night.
Suck my dick, Jack. I know I'm a fat fuck, okay?
You and Catherine still in Petaluma?
Oh, yeah. God, it's great. Do you want to know what the highlight of my day is? I wake up every morning, and I don't get a blowjob from my wife. And I usually take a shit about the size of the Transamerica pyramid. But the highlight of my day is I go down to my local Starbucks, and I watch my favorite barista frap my chino, and when she's doing it, I just grab a little glimpse of her perfect apple ass. And then everything else goes downhill from there. Because that's what fucking happens when they give you early fucking retirement. I gotta tell you, Pete, there's not a day that goes by that I don't think, I wonder if this is the day I'm gonna take my Glock and blow my fucking brains out from boredom.
Jack, what are you doing here? I mean, obviously, I don't have any money to give you. I mean, you're wasting your time.
Money? Pete, if I wanted money, I wouldn't be looking for clients next to a dumpster, no offense. I still have connections in the OPD.
What's that?
That is a list of Fred Ross's known associates.
Who the fuck is Fred Ross?
Who the fuck is Fred Ross? The drug dealer who got his head bashed in with brass knuckles. Now, maybe the murder was personal. Maybe someone on this list is your guy, Pete.
Why would he resurface 25 years later?
Do you watch the news? Are you watching what's happening in the world today? Everybody hates everybody, Pete. Everybody's mad about everything. There's road rage and Twitter wars. It's not hunky-dory like it used to be. It's not. And beyond that, this is for Shari. Now, you said she deserved this. This motherfucker deserves a death penalty. And we're gonna give it to him.
Just like last time, huh?
Okay. You accidentally send the wrong guy into a coma for a couple days.
5 days, Jack. 5 days he was in a coma, but you want to go ahead and tell yourself that so you can sleep at night? Fine, kudos to you. For me, it wasn't worth
it. Got you sober.
Give me that silver lining bullshit. Hey. Hey. Natalie's getting married in a month.
Oh, shit. I'll bet I wasn't invited. I'll send a toaster. I'm sorry. Pete, I don't know why I'm being a fucking asshole, especially about that. I'll bet she's beautiful just like her mom, huh? Please, give her my congratulations. All around congratulations.
Yeah, okay, thanks. Hey, listen, you know, I should be going anyway.
Hey. Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Pete. It wasn't your fault.
Thanks.
I've got tapes for sale. Buy me a beer and I'll give you a discount.
This is about as dead as I've ever seen this place. Look at this fucking place.
Next week, man. Oh, better flyers.
There's not gonna be a next week.
Drag me out of here kicking and screaming.
You know what? Maybe you should talk to Natalie before you think about moving in with us.
At first, I didn't even know it was him. Almost nothing left of his face. They said there was something metal that killed him. Like brass knuckled or something like that. He lived in San Francisco for his whole life and he worked here for 40 years. Who would do this?
A drug dealer, Asian liquor store owner. The only thing these two guys have in common is somebody smashed in their faces.
I don't know, it might be nothing.
Mr. Wong's nephew said
there's no security footage at all.
Well, you know why? The son of a bitch stole the security cameras. It's all gone.
It's a dead end for us, buddy.
Thanks.
Of the donors we're meeting this weekend. I'd call, but the guy's wife is real judgy. You know, one of those artsy trophy wives.
Bill?
Yeah, Bill. She's probably bitter that she couldn't put that $200,000 arts degree to use. It reminds me how grateful I am that I transferred over to marketing.
You definitely dodged that bullet.
You said you didn't like anal.
What are you talking about?
The charges on your credit card, Harry. I saw them. Porn and strippers, really?
It was a bachelor party.
Sure it was. We're starting therapy again. I'm calling Dr. Berberick first thing in the morning.
That's really not necessary.
Yes, it is. You know, if I could just drop a GPS to your dick, I would do that too.
How soon are you looking to move?
Soon. Yeah, real soon.
So on the phone, you said it was 1650. Is there any wiggle room in there?
2650.
Jesus. What's the deposit?
3500.
So you want 6150 to move in here?
It's a remodel. Notice the granite countertop?
Yeah. I'll be in touch.
Want an application?
Suck my dick.
I would totally pick you up, but people are going to start arriving any minute, and I'm not done cleaning yet.
Sean has to get home until 5:30.
Yeah, no, listen, I'll just take the bus.
No. That's ridiculous. I'm going to call you an Uber.
Oh, honey, don't
waste your money.
Too late. The driver is en route. His name is Trevor. He's in Silver Prius.
Really? That's it?
That's it. Welcome to the 21st century. I have a feeling you're going to be hooked.
Yo. Trevor?
Anyway, so here I am about to be officially homeless. Not even Oakland is affordable anymore. I mean, I'm gonna have to ask my daughter if I can crash at her place for a while.
So is that what they call gentrification? Urban renewal? Racial dislocation? Thought that shit only happened to black people, man. That shit's crazy.
Yeah, well, my bills don't see color, apparently.
Oh, that's real.
What about you? What's your story?
Born and raised in Oakland, just like you. Except I came up in the public housing, so, you know. Same as any other ghetto, though, man. You know what I'm saying? Crime, crack, drugs, prostitution, all out in the open and shit, man. I was like, man, this ain't no way to live, man. So, got my act together, got me a little degree online. I'm just doing this little driving thing right now, man. Just, you know, just trying to pay back these student loans. Just grinding, man.
Hey, you and me both, huh? I'll tell you, there's a lot of people out there got it easy compared to us. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, that's one way to look at it, man. But, you know, I'm about perspective, though. Remember what Teddy Roosevelt said, right?
No, what did he say?
He said, comparison is the thief of joy, right? It's a motivational therapy for you. Hey, man, you ain't got nowhere to be, I mean, like, right this second, right? You mind if I pick up my cousin right quick, man? He's gonna be coming up over here on the right.
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Right on, man. Appreciate it, man. Tested, but now to me, man, that shit look real no motherfucker, boy. The fuck you rolling around with a diamond ring in your pocket for, Pete?
It's my wife's. She's dead.
Guess she won't be missing it then, huh?
Asshole. Are you serious right now? Everything's about you. We just went to your fucking one-man show.
You don't want to go, you don't have to go.
No, that's not what I mean.
No, fuck it.
I thought you quit. Slow down, please.
You know what?
You know I hate it when you drive like that. Up that car's ass.
It's just a cigarette, Jesus.
No, it's not just a cigarette. Why don't you just grow the fuck up? What are you doing?
What does it look like?
I don't know, behave like a fucking man. And not feel like such a victim all the fucking time. What are you doing? Pete! What are you doing?
Look, just take the baby home.
I am sick and tired of being strung along on your life dream. Now, what about my life? I'm done.
Man, get him the fuck up out this car and let's roll, man. Leave that nigga seasick while you're ready.
Get your fat ass out the car, man. You ain't got no more money, Tuck D. What's this? Speak up, fool.
What it looks like.
You a cop, Pete?
Cop? Far from it.
Cuz, check this out, man.
You ain't no cop. What you doing with these files, Pete?
Trying to find the guy that killed my wife.
And you think one of the names here is the person that killed your wife, huh?
No, probably not, but maybe one of those guys know who did.
What if I told you I know one of the names on here? What if I told you I might be able to help you?
I'd say you've got my attention.
Yeah, but what you got for me?
Pete.
Come on, man. You rolling around with diamond rings, envelopes full of cash and shit. I'm sure you got something, Mo, man.
I got a Volvo. You know how to drive stick?
This whip is perfect, ain't it?
For what? Man, when are you gonna introduce me to your friend?
Didn't I say I would do it? Let me ask you something. You ever wore glasses before, Pete? Man, what's up, man? Nigga's truck right there. What's up with this fool Shiner, man?
I don't know. He probably up there catching VD.
I assume this Sherm is one of the names on the list.
Man, you're gonna have to season them questions a little bit more moderately, you feel me? Sherm get in his car, you start asking him all them questions, man. He gonna think you some kind of narc or something, man. He gonna tell you shit.
Not to mention it might get your cat peed.
And that shit's real.
And what exactly is this job?
Don't trip, all right? It's just some petty larceny. That's all we doing. I ain't asking you to drive the Bronco for me.
That sound like part of the original deal to me. Is this all part of the Prius gimmick, too? This music.
What about it?
Well, it doesn't really seem like you'd be, you know, the type of fucking guy that would listen to shit like this.
Fuck it, I'll keep it 1,000 with you, boy. What type of cars you be seeing punk-ass white people driving nowadays? Priuses, Leafs. Ever since I got this shit, man, police ain't fuck with a nigga, man.
It's true. Ever since he got the Prius, he ain't never been stopped by the police.
Now I went like this, I was like, well, fuck it, man. I'm gonna go all the way in, you feel me? I got me some fucking, some thick-ass fucking glasses, some tiny shirts, some tiny jeans, nigga. Took this bitch, put a fucking Keep Tahoe blue sticker on the back and shit.
White folks be loving some blue-ass licks.
Don't they? The motherfuckers will jump off bridges on their birthday for that bullshit. And I was like, all right, nigga, got my little outfit, you feel me? Now a nigga needs some theme music. So I said, all right, what's the whitest fucking music you ain't never gonna hear some niggas from Oakland playing when they riding around? Heavy metal, nigga. And it hit me, nigga. Well, shit, man, I started going into the archive, like, what music can I find, man? I started getting my Matt Pinfield on, you feel me? And you know what was crazy? Man, I started actually liking that shit, bro. Like early Judas Priest, some fucking Slayer, some Black Sabbath, man. I even like some shit by White Pride, man. Like, I started going to their concerts and all that shit, man. We went with these little white bras, man. They took niggas down to this fucking Lodge Rocket show. And we was all in the mosh pit and shit, boy. We fucking stomping on these white boys' heads and shit, boy. Motherfucker jumped up. He was like, fuck yeah, bro, do that shit, man. I felt like I discovered another part of myself in there, man. Like a spiritual part, you feel me?
That's real.
You look like you're ready to take it up a notch. All right, Harold?
But you don't know? You know. You know.
Sean.
Shit. Yo, baby, Harold's gotta roll.
Man, I've been texting your ass for 30 minutes.
Yo, Jay, can you switch the music to something more chill? Like Dave Matthews or something?
What? Man, fuck Dave Matthews. That motherfucker be playing 8-minute solos and shit. If you sitting in the stadium, your ass will fucking fall asleep.
Fucking like Dave Matthews. Know you?
No.
I feel like I seen you somewhere.
That's a tweet, nigga. Pointillism, y'all. That's all we in it for. Pointillism.
Say what?
Pointillism. You don't know what that is?
Take an art history lesson, nigga. Damn.
We get up in this spot, don't touch shit up on this real estate. We don't need no cash. We don't need no jewels. All we looking for is these two George Seurat paintings from the French Impressionist era. Pointillism is a style that they credit him with, that he came up with. See, we used these tiny paint dots to create his masterpiece. He revolutionized the game, man.
I thought you said this was big, homie.
It is big, fool. Fuck you think we doing?
I don't need no fucking art. I just hit the jackpot with this rich motherfucker's plastic I stole. Got me some ladies, some motherfucking champagne.
And you drank it all and them bitches ain't even here, right? See, when the dollar collapses and the Fed calls in the country's debt, quits printing big faces, man. Everybody's gonna wanna have put their money to some shit that actually holds some value, man. Like some fine art, some land, some water, some shit, man. Can't do no shit with no fucking strippers and credit cards.
All right, Wall Street. As long as I get my 20%. What the fuck you keep staring at, old man?
Yeah, I finally figured out where you know me from.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
Ross. You know me through Fred Ross.
The liquor store. That's how I know your ass. You bumped into me at the liquor store.
Yeah, I don't think so.
No, it happened. Jay, how do you know this motherfucker, man? I'm not liking this shit right now.
Nigga, shut the fuck up. This ain't no competition. It's a cooperation, man. He the driver. That's why he here. That's all your white ass need to know.
I'm gonna make it simple for you, Pete. Text me on this phone after you make sure that there ain't no house sitter up in here or some shit. We gonna come through in the Prius. We gonna come out with the shit 2 minutes later. We gonna calmly and slowly drive us up to the Prius. The Prius gonna be parked up like a mile away. And from there, you leave. You don't have no contact for at least a week. Got it?
All right, I got it.
Y'all got 2 minutes.
Fuck this. I'm calling Natalie. What the fuck do you dial this phone?
I'm not finding this. Does somebody break and start on an entry at...
Doctor, how the fuck I'm supposed to know?
They gotta get me to a hospital. Just drop me off at Highland.
What's the plan? The cops gonna think the Volvo was stolen anyway, so we ain't got a trip on that. Only thing I'm worried about is this whip right here.
You fucking hear me?
Switch the place out now.
We gotta get me to a hospital. Highland's 10 minutes from here.
fuck up, you trigger-happy motherfucker. We go to Highland, we all go down.
I'ma fucking kill you when this is done. That's right. Look away, you fucking bald, fat piece of shit. This is all your fucking fault.
I tell you what, I'm gonna fucking try it, huh? I'll fucking crack your skull open just like I did your little buddy Fred Ross.
You ain't killed Fred Ross.
The hell I didn't.
Doing the Tesla killed Ross. You ain't driving no Tesla.
What? What'd you say?
Sir. I know this white boy didn't just die in my car.
That's not good.
How long ago did my friend Harold leave?
Who? Thank you. He's been gone about 45 minutes. But he's probably out back.
Which is his car?
He has a Dave Matthews sticker on the back. Can't miss it.
I left with that fool. Everybody up in there seen that shit. We got a dead white woman on our hands, man. You know what that shit means.
Give me one of his cigarettes.
Thought you quit.
I can hide his car.
What you offer?
Give me my ring back, and I'll stash the car.
Where?
I got a buddy in Petaluma. I can stash it there. You got a deal?
Your look. Some kind of hipster.
Is that what you call that?
Well, then, I'm gonna take my tea and head upstairs.
Okay. Good night. Hey, Peter. You know, in the course of my career, I've been on 5,000 crime scenes. So little details, they're not lost on me. Like when a guy shows up at my house with blood under his fingernails. What the fuck are you doing here in my house?
Is there a place I could have a cigarette?
I thought you quit that too. No, you can't smoke in here. She'll have a nervous breakdown. Let's go outside.
know it's leaking oil, right? What the hell is this? Get the hell out.
Look at that.
Huh. It's one of those tracking devices.
What's it for?
Usually you see these when some spouse thinks the other one's fucking around them and they put it up under the car. I can't imagine why a tweaker would have it, though. I mean, the cops can't use them, you know, the judges don't allow it. It's weird. Pete, what does it matter?
Man, I really fucked up. You gotta help me out of this shit.
You fucking wake her up. Listen to me, Peter. Nobody is gonna care that he's gone. Nobody. The world's a better place without him. That said, did you get any information before he went bye-bye?
He said the guy that murdered Fred Ross was driving a Tesla, but you know, one of those electric cars. But I mean, he was dying, man. He wasn't making a lot of sense.
Listen to me. You called me this morning. I called my buddies at the department. Would you believe that when Wong got killed, some hipsters in the neighborhood had a fucking drone in the air? They caught it. Now, they sent me the footage from downtown. You can't see the perp's face, but I'm pretty sure it's a Tesla. Let me just go pull it up on the computer. You know what? Try being Superman for a while, not Clark Kent. Finish your cig and come inside. Thank you. I got it. Check this out.
While you're at it, why don't you give me a whiskey, too? Grab me a little social bitch. Give me a bottle.
What the fuck is wrong with you, Pete?
Hey, I'm just cutting some slack, obviously. He's had a rough day, right?
I guess the bigger they are, the harder they fall off the wagon, that is.
Natalie, hey, it's me. Yeah, he's here. Do you mind picking him up?
How long we gotta sit in here? We doing something with the priest?
Nah, we over here hiding in plain sight, boy. Unless you got a better idea.
Cuz, I'll pack your ski clothes. We're going to Tahoe.
Where are the restrooms? This beet juice is kicking in again. You ever had 12 ounces of beet juice?
I should have known better.
Natalie, listen to me. I saw him.
You're not making any sense.
The man that killed your mother.
This is what you want to go back to? Well, I'm not going to stop you. I'm done.
Natalie, listen.
I know what happened that night. Everyone always said it was your fault. You were the one driving the car, not her. And you left her there. She was a sitting duck, and you left her alone.
You don't know what you're talking about, so you shut the fuck up.
Don't pretend this whole sober charade you've been putting on for the last 6 years erases any of that. And don't come to my wedding. Hey, do you have a cigarette I can bum off you?
Sorry, this is my last one.
I got a fresh pack.
Thank you.
Here you go. You really shouldn't smoke. It's dangerous.
Pete, where's Natalie, man? I've been trying to get a hold of her. Where is she?
Oh, Sean. Oh, man.
It's 5 a.m, Pete. Look, tell me where Natalie is, please. I've been trying to look for her. Where is she?
Oh, she got mad at me. She left the bar.
Shit, man. I gotta go, man.
Oh, shit. We gotta call the cops.
What the fuck is this guy doing? Shit. Sorry, Natalie. Don't worry. He's got this. It's just
Sherry!
Sherry.
Then wake your ass up.
Where am I?
Worry about where the fuck you at, boy. Originally, I was gonna leave your fat ass down the road somewhere. Slump, nigga. It's your lucky day, Pete. Because of you, I got me a good luck charm. Motherfucking black card. Endless flow of credit.
It's not really a good time for me to be taking a road trip.
Motherfucker, this ain't no fucking road trip. Put that shit on. You gonna help us rob this Harold Price. Let's get my ass shot for your dumb ass.
You're part owner of some big ass companies. I tell you, Harold Price got so much motherfucking money, he don't even know what to do with it. Nigga got more money than God. That's why he got a place in Maui, LA, New York, and this lakefront property right here in Tahoe.
Do you know Steph Curry?
No.
Do you know Steph Curry?
No.
But aren't you guys professional basketball players?
Lacrosse.
Fucking kidding me right now? I don't need no art. I just hit the jackpot with this rich motherfucker's plastic I stole. Got me some ladies, some motherfucking champagne.
So I got me a good luck charm.
They said there was something metal, like brass knuckles.
Fred Ross was driving a Tesla.
Listen to me, I saw him. The metal that killed your mother.
Motherfucker looked like he just seen a ghost.
Let's just get this over with.
Hell yeah, boy. I'm feeling good about this one, boy. There's no cars there. What about the garage, though?
Okay, let me see.
Come on, nigga, this ain't no time for no flying lessons. I thought you knew how to work this shit.
It won't let me fly over the property for some reason.
Didn't you say this drone had range up over a mile?
It does, but it won't let me.
Han?
I'm getting ready to go to hot yoga.
You want to go to Tahoe instead?
Damn. Wade. You sure they're going for the weekend?
Hell yeah, the website said they had a fundraiser in D.C. all weekend. We good.
Damn. Them white folks weren't lying. This lake is blue as fuck.
We have a fundraiser with Karen and Ed in D.C., remember?
Something more important came up.
What?
You.
What is this for?
Happy early anniversary, baby.
Oh, I am going to go back.
Doing your thing, man. You're a white alibi this trip.
don't trust your ass, man.
So we're gonna bounce or what?
Might as well. We ain't got shit else to do yet.
Hold up. Is that a hot tub? White people.
Hmm. I mean, rich white people. Don't get it twisted.
Man, I could get used to living like this.
What you mean? Used to living like what?
Living like white people. You know? Wine tasting. Going on a hot air balloon. Shit like that, man.
You can do all that shit, man. You ain't gotta be white to do that shit. Just look at Pete, man. Shit he told you about his life. Shit he going through right now. You think he got hot air balloons? Spa treatments every day? Man, he ain't got shit.
Guess you didn't need to bring your golf clubs after all.
Prez! Prez, nigga, pull your shit up and come on, nigga, they home!
Look at that. What? Why are all the lights on?
Might be part of the new security system they installed yesterday.
Prez! Come on, so what are you stopping for? Man, come on!
I'm staying here.
Why don't you go upstairs, see if your jewelry's still here?
Do you think they took my jewelry?
And if they did, we'll replace that too.
Okay.
Sweetheart, while you're up there, why don't you freshen up? We're not gonna let this ruin our romantic weekend.
I feel so fucking violated. Where's your shirt?
That sink exploded on me.
What was that noise?
There's air in the pipes in that bathroom. It's horrible.
It's all gone. My pearls, diamonds, everything.
Something tells me we're gonna get them back real soon.
I know. I know it could be replaced. It's just... Do you think the thieves are still around here?
No one would hang around.
In the oven, and in a couple hours, we're gonna have a nice meal. We're gonna shake all this off. Why don't you take a nice hot shower? What the fuck is wrong with you?
It's him. Killed my wife. Killed my daughter.
Pete, you knew this shit the whole goddamn time. You didn't fucking say nothing. I don't fucking kill your ass, my goddamn son. You led us straight to the goddamn devil's lair.
No, you led us here.
Listen, man. It's two against one. We in this shit together now.
Sherman?
No.
Hey. Where's Sherman?
I thought Sean Payne done it!
Hope you enjoyed yourself on my dime.
Get out.
Oh my God.
Get out. Where'd that ring come from?
My husband gave it to me. You can have it.
Did he kill her?
What?
My daughter, did he kill her?
There must be some kind of mistake. My husband, he's just a venture capitalist.
You imagined, Pete.
Harry, you know him? He's just looking for his daughter. Please tell him you don't know where she is.
Where's Natalie?
Well, you're her dad. You tell me.
Well, fuck you. You took that ring from her.
No, she gave that to me at that bar where you work at. She traded it, actually, for a cigarette.
But you fucking lie to me. Natalie would never do that.
Sometimes people just need a shoulder to cry on. And she certainly never had yours.
What the fuck are you talking about, Harold? Will you tell him the truth? Tell him that you don't know where she is.
Should I tell him that I don't know where she is, or should I tell him the truth? After all, it was you who was driving the car that night, wasn't it? Macho man. Yeah, that's who you are. You ever put on a pair of these? Never mind, I can tell the answer's no. You'd have been real proud of Natalie. She was a very tough girl. She didn't scream nearly as much as her mom did. And it all comes down to that. How's that make you feel? Deflated? You should have taken my advice, Pete. You crossed a line that now cannot be uncrossed. Something that happened 30 years ago. That makes you worse than me.
Nobody deserves what you did.
Sure. But I gave your wife a chance to apologize for your bad behavior, and it just didn't take. Now your daughter, on the other hand, now she is talented. I'm going to invest in her singing career. I'm going to be her first big break.
Sammy. She loved that dog, right? And he used to do all kind of tricks, like walk on his hind legs, spin around in circles, you know, all that cute little poodle shit. And one day, my mama was walking, and she ran into this pit bull. And it looked mean, but she gave it the benefit of the doubt. She put her hand out to pet it, and growled at her. Well, little Sammy, he wanted to protect her from that pit, so he started barking at it, and that was all it took for that pit to put little Sammy on his back, wrap his jaw around his neck, and kill him. Mama didn't do nothing about it. She thought maybe it was Sammy's fault. He shouldn't have barked.
Is this it?
Yeah, that's him right there.
Hey, man, you're the groom? Congratulations.
One day, my neighbor's pit bull came up missing. He came out front, calling his name, yelling down the street. And everybody was so concerned about his pit bull, not because they felt bad for the neighbor, Really, they didn't want that dog wreaking any more havoc on anybody in the neighborhood. What they didn't know was I had to put that dog down myself.
Like all those bodies with a fun, like a summer.